So in today's session, we'll discuss about what is accounting information system. Accounting information system is a collection of storing and processing financial and accounting data. So we have discussed in a previous lesson there what is accounting, what is information, and what is system. So as per accounting is nothing but identifying, recording, measuring, classifying, summarizing financial information. Or in just in brief, recording of financial transaction is called accounting. It is the term of business where the day-to-day routine transactions are recorded and they are measured in the form of transaction. And as accountant, the accountant is classifying that transactions in books and summarize in the financial information in the form of financial reports. The financial reports may be trial balance, may be profit and loss account, income and expenditure, or at the end a balance sheet. That we call as a accounting. As second, information, the term information, it provides the answer to a question when data processed called information. So whenever the data is processed, so that data gives some kind of information. Information may be any kind. Suppose if you ask any question, when I ask any questions to you, then when you are giving some output to me, that we called as an information about. Okay, for example, if you ask any question related to your subject, if I raised any question, so what do you mean by data? So when you are answering me as a data, so that data may be nothing but a raw fact and information about a particular. So that we called as an information. When it is the question, when it is asked, and when that question is gives any details, that details we called as a information. So in the form of accounting, any business transaction, when it is maybe a received transaction in the form of a receipt or in the form of payment or in the form of any kinds of transactions, so that gives some information details. So that we called as an information. So here raw fact and figures. Raw fact and figures means it may be consist numbers, characters, details about that, all we call as what a information. And the third word is system. A system is a group of one or two or more interrelated components or subsystems that serve a common purpose is called system. So system is what? System is a group of one or two more interrelated components. So in why we system we used, the system is used to solve the problems. So it may be one system or it may be a group or a number of systems, and that systems are connected. See, now we are talking on the line, we are delivering the lecture on the line, you are connected to me and I am connected to me on the line, and we are serving the some lessons and we are delivering some information to the students, and I am getting some queries from your end, and I am solving that things. That we called as online, we are giving the lecture and you are listening. So it is a group of information, so the group of the interrelated components, it may be connected to one or it may be connected to the number of systems that serves a common purpose, that we call as a system. So in brief, accounting is a recording, measuring, classifying, and summarizing of financial information, that we call as transaction. But in simple terms, recording of financial transactions in a business is called accounting. And information, it is a question to about what you are giving, and that gives some meaningful details, that we call as what information. And in a system, it may be a group or it may be a subsystems that are interconnected, and that serves up for a common purpose, we call as a system. So in accounting information structure, the business uses number of these R, accounting information and system. So for what purpose generally that business collect this all these accounting information system? For the processing purpose. So in they need to collect, they store it, they manage it, and they processing, and they retrieve as and when the reports are required. So accounting information structure is a design for the purpose of to collecting, storing, and managing and process wherever it is required, such a reports are presented to the management. The peoples who are involved in this, the users who are involved in this accounting information systems are the accountants, the consultants, the business analyst, the managers, the chief financial officers, or CEOs, auditors, regulators, and tax agencies. The many users are involved in an accounting information system, as your business is categorized into many levels, basically on the top, middle, and operation levels. So there are number of users are involved. And when these users are interacted with the business from one to another, there the informations are collected from this all the internal external sources, and that are used to store and manage and process wherever these informations are required, that has to be presented to all the levels. So these are the peoples who are involved, the users, internal and external users who are involved in accounting information structures are accountants. Accountants also plays one role, consultants are also plays one role, business analysts plays role, managers, CEOs, auditors, and number of other peoples, maybe from internally or for externally, they are a part of your accounting information system. So in short, AIS is a collection of storage and processing financial and accounting data that is used by a decision maker. Why these informations are very used for us? Because it collects and it stores our day-to-day informations, day-to-day very confidential or processed information, or your regular informations of your business that you are serving to your institution. So that has to be stored and that has to be processed, and that should be presented in a proper manner, and in that we call as accounting information system. So your storage, processing, financial, accounting data, these are the terms that are required for this all the above, which are that what we have categorized here, accountants, consultants. They are the decision makers. They collect all this information from the sources, from the departments. And why these informations are required for them? Because they are the decision makers. These accountants, consultants, business analysts, CEOs, regulator, tax agencies, they are the decision makers to your business, to your concerns. So they give why all this information are required for them? Because they give some decisions to your business. So that's why in simple terms, AIS is defined as a collection, storage, and process your financial and accounting data that is used by the decision makers. Who are the decision makers here? The accountants, consultants, and analysts, CEOs. There are number of these are the top level high authorities. They are comes under this. And why all these kinds of informations are required from them? Because they are they require all this information. Hello. Elements of system. So every system is a group of one or more interrelated components or subsystems that serves a common purpose. So that we call as a system. So every system is not a single. It is a sub. It is connected with a number of subsystems. So now, what are the elements of systems? All system has some common elements. In general, a system is a group of one or more interrelated systems that serves a common purpose. So this is the simple meaning of a system. So every system has but multiple components. A system may be one or it may contain more than one. That we call as a subsystem. When systems are connected with the number of other subsystems, and they serves as a one common purpose. So it consists some elements. That is one, relatedness, subsystem, purpose, system decomposition, system interdependencies. So here, relatedness. What do you mean by this relatedness? A common purpose relates the multiple parts of the system, and each part functions independently of the others. See, related means it is connected with the one to other parts of your systems. See, when a system is connected with the other subsystem, every subsystem has to be functions correctly. Okay, it should be related into one to another, and it should perform all the tasks. The task, if you want to complete one particular system, the what are the its other systems which are connected to this, it should work. Then only we can achieve that particular information about that particular system. So relatedness means the purpose of your system consisting of number of subsystems, and each system should relates one to another and it gives the particular results. For example, when you are connected on the internet, now the meeting is, I have started at the lesson and you are all are connected. If one system is not connected, if I am not connected correctly, I am not audible correctly, video is not audible, lesson is not shared correctly, then we can't say it is not serving the particular common information about the particular system. So relatedness means it should be related your all the subsystems which are connected to your main system, so that it should be functions correctly and independently of the others. When it is connected to one system, so other subsystems should be individually, it should be connected and it should be functionally correct. Okay, it should be related one to another. So that is we called as a relatedness. Second, subsystem. As we just discussed, system is, it consists subsystem. So subsystem, so when you are having the largest part of your system, we called as a subsystem. The one system cannot we say, when the one system connected with the small parts that are connected, and when it is a large part of system, we called as a subsystem. Okay, for example, educational system. So educational system, university system, college system, each college has a consist of number of sub other division, other disciplines, when they all are integrated, and we call it as a one college. So university has affiliated colleges, affiliated departments, they all are interconnected. In business system, one firms, one office and other departments are connected, interconnected, and we call it as a large system connected with the small subsystem, we call it as a subsystem. The purpose, a system must serve at least one purpose or many. Why we use this system? Because it gives some information, it serves some common purpose. For that purpose, a system must serve at least one purpose. Without, see, this live class, why we are engaging? Because it gives some, it delivering lectures to you. It giving some, the objective of this class right now is because I am delivering lecture on the line. It giving the some informations to you. So that it should have some common purpose when you are using a particular system in a business. A system decomposition. So decomposition means dividing your big system into the small subsystem. So composition and decomposition. Composition means mixing, decomposition means separating. So that all small parts you are dividing to one to another or into small units, and later you are integrating in one and taking the information, gathering the collecting that all information to the main system, we call it as a system decomposition. So here it is the process of dividing the system into smaller subsystem parts. By decomposing a system, the overall system has a hierarchy and it creates the links between subordinates and a subsystem. So each subordinate system performs one or more specific function to the overall subsystem. In simple meaning, the big system, the large part of the systems are connected with the small subsystems, and that all subsystems has its links to the main system, and each link should perform some specific task. For example, if the college has a number of other departments and all the departments have the system, and they each individual department should give that all the information to the main office. Okay, so that we called as what, a system decomposition. Or in a university or in a business organization, in your business concern, you have the number of all other departments like finance department, marketing department, purchases, sales and all this, and all these are departments are connected to the EDP departments, okay, electronic data processing departments. So they are collecting all these other departments. They have linked with all this into the main systems with the help of supports of other systems, and they have to give the specific information to their main system. So that we call as a system decomposition. Why this system decomposition are required? Because when you are working with the large system, definitely you have to divide your parts of your system into the subsystems, and they should give the some more specific information to the main system. That we call as a system decomposition. Subsystem interdependency. The next important element is subsystem interdependency. The goal is depending on the effective functioning and harmonious interaction of its subsystem, because it plays very vital information to your system. A system depends only when it functioning of all subsystems. If all subsystems are interacted correctly, then only the effective informations you are collecting. If a subsystem fails or become defective and can no longer meet its specific objective, the overall system will fail to meet its objective. See here, the very simple example, let me explain now on this interdependency. Now this on the line, when it is you are connecting with the number of users on the line. Now right now you are all this all final years are connected to me here. I am the hosting the meeting, and if I failed to get disconnected, so rest all automatically disconnected to the class. Okay, similarly, if you are working, one system is depending into another, second system is connected to another in a business. For example, the accounts department or marketing, sales or budget, these the finance, all these departments are in your concern, and one department is depending on to another department. So for the accountant who is working in a department, he is to have the information from the all the rest all from the all the staffs, not from the only you. They are collecting from the one to another departments. So one department is depending on the another, second department is depending on the another, and that all the informations when you are collecting and interacting, then only you can work smoothly and you can coordinate it into one to another. So in simple terms, interaction of it's a subsystem. Your main systems are connected with the number of system, and number of systems has to be interacted individually with the main subsystems. So that we call as a interdependent, means one department is depending on to another department. One department is dependent on the another department. Okay, for example, a store department, a purchase department, sales department, like that, one department are connected into another department. If it is a processing channel service, then one process is completed, then it goes to the next, then it goes to and so on. So that we call as a subsystem interdependency. For example, here there is one diagram. So that it shows two importance of the study, how the information system is and how the system decomposition and subsystem interdependent. See here. Here automobile, the primary subsystem, here I have taken one example about the automobile. See, automobile is a one system, okay, and these consist of fuel system, these are the subsystem: fuel system, propulsion system, electrical system, brake system. Fuel system again consists fuel tank, fuel pump, fuel injector. Propulsion system consists engine, transmission, rear axis, wheels. Electrical systems, light, ignition, radios, batteries. Brake system consists brake, pedal, master, cylinder, brake lines and disc. See, all these all are subsystem and all are independent. The final result of this diagram is what? The automobile, the vehicle what you are having, it consists of all the parts and it interconnected into one to another, and the inter connected and internally it perform the function itself. Okay, one by one. If for example, if a fuel pump is not working, definitely this will not work and it will gives the effect for the rest of all the system. Or these all are correct and here some battery problem, then definitely it gives here some problems to you. It gives the effect to the other system also. So when these all are connected, small units and interconnected, and finally the objective of the purpose of this system is what? Because you can have this system for your riding purpose. For that we call as a system decomposition and system interdependency.